It's 2019. Will PGD help you conceive with IVF? PGD involves testing embryos for abnormalities during IVF before they are transferred into the uterus. Will it help you? Stay tuned to find out. There are many different types of genetic tests that can be done on embryos. There are a bunch of different acronyms. To learn the difference, watch this video. The type of testing that is most common, and the type we are going to be talking about today, is sometimes referred to as PGS, CCS, or PGT-a. This type of testing looks to see if an embryo has the correct number of chromosomes. What is the correct number? 46. A normal, healthy embryo has 46 chromosomes. There are 23 pairs of each chromosome. Sometimes, however, mistakes are made, so an embryo might have an extra chromosome or a missing chromosome. Sometimes, embryos can have a bunch of different chromosome abnormalities. We know a lot about embryos with abnormalities in the number of chromosomes. First, these embryos are a lot less likely to implant in the uterus, so the chance for a positive pregnancy test goes way down. Second, if an embryo does implant, the chance for a miscarriage goes way up. The big question is, will selecting an embryo for transfer that has the correct number of chromosomes using PGD increase the chance that the embryo will implant in the uterus? The answer is well agreed upon by all doctors. It will absolutely make the chance for implantation higher. The next question is, in general, will selecting embryos with PGD improve the chances that women doing IVF will have a live, born, and healthy baby? This answer is a little trickier. The quick answer is that it may not help everybody. Let's take the example of younger women. Younger women make less abnormal embryos. Doing PGD is less likely to change which embryo the doctor selects for transfer, so there is less overall benefit for testing the embryos. Older women make more abnormal embryos. The higher her age, the higher her percentage of abnormal embryos. So in this group, there is a definite benefit to doing PGD. What constitutes old? At IVF1, we recommend women consider doing PGD if they are 37 years of age or older.
Did you like this video? Well, like this video. If you have a question, leave it in the comments. We'll answer. Click the link in the description to become a patient or become a subscriber for new episodes weekly. It's like having your own fertility specialist in your phone.